What's up guys, Sal here. So it's not often that Windows generate huge buzz among the content creators and consumers, but Windows 11 has certainly sparked a fire of interest. And the reason for that is the entire build of the operating system has been leaked well before the official announcement date from Microsoft, which falls on June 24th. This means you can install Windows 11 right now by downloading the build, but that doesn't mean you should because it's still unofficial and could have some bugs. But as you can see, Microsoft has made some big changes. The first thing to notice is the center start menu and taskbar icons looking similar to Apple's macOS. Honestly, when I first saw this, I absolutely hated it because it looks more like Windows 95. But I quickly changed my mind when I saw the dark mode. It looks good. I won't say it's the best looking operating system out there, but it looks miles better than the light mode. That said, there's also a setting that moves the start menu and icons to the left where they've always been if you don't really like the change. Also, Microsoft has dropped live tiles for icons and grid layout and replaced it with more simplistic transparent icons. Some of you may like this decision and some of you may not, but there's a good reason why they did it. You see, the majority of people use smartphones these days, whether it's an iPhone or an Android phone, and if they're using the desktop for the very first time, they expect it to look familiar to what they're used to. This holds especially true for kids who grew up using an iPad. When they grow up and need a real computer, they need something that's a little more intuitive that they're used to. Anyway, the start menu has been generally simplified and also hold pinned apps, recent files, and quicker access to restart and shut down buttons. Interestingly, quite a bit of design choices has translated from the unreleased Windows 10X. The 10X was designed specifically for dual-screen foldable devices and was meant to compete with Google's Chrome OS, but they cancelled it for some reason. Also, one of the new features of Windows 11 includes snap controls that one can access from the maximize button on all apps. The feature allows the user to quickly snap windows side by side or arrange them in sections on your desktop. Microsoft has also changed the startup tune. Now it sounds like this. That said, I really don't know how to feel about Windows 11 because it seems different, but it's basically the same. Quite disappointed that this is being named Windows 11, especially being that this is nothing more than the UI elements of Windows 10X being integrated into the current Windows 10 OS. Microsoft seems to be following Apple, considering that after nearly two decades, they moved from the version 10.x to version 11. Definitely not worthy of a version change. Also, I never liked the look of macOS, but now Windows 11 is starting to look like it, and that's really frustrating. Anyway, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.